The dollar Swiss for October the 11th. We can see on the weekly chart that we did have a reversal on last week. We traded initially, we traded below the prior week's low, and we traded below 3 weeks low, and we are below a structural point, which is the 103.71, and yet we have failed to or the dollar did not capitulate to the downside, and there was no sell-off. On the contrary, we did reverse back above those three trigger points, and now we do have a close near the high, and that would indicate again, which confirms what we have seen on the dollar index and confirms also what we have seen on the dollar yen. And as of that point, even though we still do not have a buy on the dollar Swiss, but we do not have a sell signal either, so we should not be selling or shorting the dollar Swiss, but we will be looking to buying the dollar Swiss on a trade above the 103.71. We are going to look at the daily now to identify an entry point. As you see on the daily chart, for the last 5 days we have been still moving sideways, and that move sideways has been now for the last couple of weeks, and we have been unable to trade lower. If we are going, as I said, we are getting those reversals on short covering rally in the dollar yen, and in the and we have seen in the dollar index. So we are not, as I said, we're going to refrain now from taking any short on the dollar Swiss unless we do trade below a selling point. And in this case, our selling point would be the low of the prior days ago, which is the 102.57. So we're going to go short the dollar Swiss only if it does trade below 102.57, and then we are going to be looking at the intraday to be taking buy signals on the dollar Swiss. So our structure long, or our long position, should be on a trade above any of the prior daily highs or above the structure point, which is the 103.71. It's not a major structure point, but it is a prior momentum low, and we should be looking at that to initiate a long position. So we are going to go to the radar screen so we can set up our entry price points. So our long position, our long buy, is above the 103.71. The shorting point is 102.57, and the structure long in this case is the same as our long point, so that's going to be the 103.71. We'll go now to the intraday chart, and you can see that we do have a, on Thursday we did trade below several days lows, and we have pushed all the way through towards after the New York session to put a high at, by testing the daily high of 103.51, just about 20 pips below the structural point. And then we had a fairly mild decline, even though it's about 35 pips, but we did close at the market side. So even that close, as long as it's above the market side, it is considered as a positive close. And in the way we are going to trade now the Tokyo session, or even the London session for tomorrow, we are going to be looking at, we are filtering the first sell out of the opening range, we are going to take the second sell. So we're not going to take the first sell, and our short is going to be the second sell, which is in this case below the 2 days low, which in this case will be the 102, which I had here on the radar screen, which is the 102.57. So we're only going to go short the dollar Swiss below the 102.57, which is right below these lows. These areas are all still considered to be a strong support, and we should be just be careful without, because we might be getting, as I said, a short covering rally in the dollar. So we have to be conservative when we are entering our short trades. So I'm going to put the 102.57 here. And that is going to be our short point. I'm going to color it red. And of course you cannot see it because it is below. It's right there. There's your 102.57, which is below the prior day's low, and this is going to be our shorting. So we have a long distance before we can actually trigger the short sign.